capital budgeting. Learning objectives. Learning objectives. Point number one. Stop talking. Learning objectives. Point number one. Average rate of return. Point number one. Average rate of return. Or accounting rate of return. Average rate of return or accounting rate of return. Bracket la ARR. In bracket write ARR. These are accepted abbreviations ARR. Point number two. Payback period. Point number two, payback period. Point number three, discounted payback period. Discounted payback period. Point number four, net present value. Point number four, net present value. Bracket la NPV. Net present value in bracket NPV. Bracket close. Point number five, internal rate of return. Internal rate of return. Internal rate of return. Bracket IRR. Internal rate of return, bracket right, IRR. Point number six, profitability index or benefit cost ratio. Profitability index or benefit cost ratio. Profitability index or benefit cost ratio. Bracket la PI. Bracket right PI or BCR. PI or BCR. Bracket close. Point number seven. Point number seven. Cash flow estimation. Cash flow estimation and decision making. Point number seven, cash flow estimation and decision making. Cash flow estimation and decision making. Point number eight, NPV versus IRR. NPV versus IRR. India versus Australia Maripa. NPV versus IRR. NPV versus IRR. In bracket right, conflict. In bracket right, conflict. We call us NPV IRR, conflict. Okay, NPV versus IRR. Bracket right, conflict. Bracket close. Within that right, A. Within the drive, A. Life disparity. Within the drive, A. Life disparity. A. Life disparity. Bracket la concept of. life disparity in bracket right concept of EAB and EAC. Life disparity in bracket concept of EAB and EAC. EAB and EAC. We'll later learn the expansion bracket. EAB na equated annuity benefit. EAC na equated annuity cost, and I'll be discussing that later. Point B. Timing disparity. Point B. Timing disparity. Or cash flow disparity. Timing disparity or cash flow disparity. In bracket write concept of. In bracket write concept of MNPV. Concept of MNPV and MIRR. MNPV and MIRR. MNPV na modified net present value. MIRR na modified IRR. Everybody, are you following or not? Now, bracket close. Point number 6 samana. Correct. Point number? Okay, point number 9. Okay, now. Capital rationing problems. Point number 9. Capital rationing problems. Within that right, A. Divisible and indivisible projects. A. Divisible and indivisible projects. A. Divisible and indivisible projects. B. Capital rationing with idle funds. Point B. Capital rationing with idle funds. Point C. Capital rationing with delayed start. Point C. Capital rationing with delayed start. Capital rationing with delayed start. Point number 9 or 10 na? Point number 10. Long-term fund approach versus. Long-term fund approach versus. Equity shareholders approach. Long-term fund approach versus. Equity shareholders approach. Long-term fund approach versus. Equity shareholders approach. Bracket right, optional. We may discuss, may not, uncertain whether they are in IPCC or not. Okay. Given an IPCC study material, one or two sum, IPCC study material is copy and paste from the final in this chapter. In that given, but not asked in the examination till now. Are you following not? So, I just put as what? Optional. Okay. Next. This is regarding the learning objectives in this chapter. What? Capital budgeting. Enough. After overheads, we are seeing a chapter with so many learning objectives, right or not? Yes, and marginal costing also has something around 10 to 11. Like the standard costing also had what? Something around 10 to 11. And this chapter also is of the same league. Can I proceed on? Now, what I am going to do is, I am going to dictate you some introduction points. Okay? You will note it down and then I will start discussing that. Today seems to be like a theory class. Okay, okay. You have to what? Be alert. Already you are sleeping only. Don't go to deep sleep. Always what? Be awake and listen to something that's being discussed. You are on the side. More of theoretical discussion, it looks like, but this is going to get used to the chapter. Problem areas will start doing in the next class. Okay, now this chapter students find it difficult if they don't understand time value of money properly. For us, this is going to be a very easy chapter. You see, what is there in this chapter? Like that, the easiness will be there because you have done about what? Time value of money very elaborately. Every chapter which you are going to do from now onwards, does not seem to be as difficult as what it is portrayed. Okay. Everywhere I say, how we are discussing lucidly and with not so many formulas. You should always put formulas, formats. It makes very confusing, very not user friendly, but we'll be discussing this way. Institute would have practice when only use is to take the questions and not look at the answers for our subject. Can I start or not? Now, first write features of capital budgeting decision. Roman letter 1, features of capital budgeting decision. Don't talk. Roman letter 1, features of capital budgeting decision. Roman letter 1, features of capital budgeting decision. Copy this quickly. Finish copying. Don't draw the auto shapes and all. Write only the alphabets. Copy as fast as possible. Shall I pussy? Can I proceed now? Finish copying up. Next. Roman letter 2. Types of capital budgeting decision. I said it is more of a theoretical introduction, but necessary to get into the chapters. Okay. Get into the chapter. Capital budgeting decision. This is a long-term investment decision. We can give lot of examples for capital budgeting decision. A company is having an old machinery, main machine for the company that is going to manufacture product. It's having an old machinery. It wants to decide to replace with the new machinery. This is what decision? Long-term decision, long-term investment decision. Company is now having already one plant, okay. It is having a plant in Hyderabad. It wants to open a new manufacturing plant in Manali. Are you following what I am saying? In that case, your new factory is going to be opened. That is what decision? Long-term decision. Your new project is started. A new project is started as well as what? Long-term decision, capital budgeting decision. Recent example, Suzuki Corporation is going planning to start car manufacturing plant in Gujarat. Yes or no? In Kalipatiya, where Maruti Suzuki did not start, Maruti came out. What is starting is what? Suzuki Corporation is starting a big car manufacturing plant in Gujarat with so many crores of investment. Is what decision? Long-term investment decision. Tata introduced nano car, yes or no? Nano car introduction, plant building is what? A capital investment decision, right or not? Ranbaxy, a pharmaceutical company, is introducing a new drug into the market. New drug has been developed. Now they are going to produce, patent it, sell it. It is what decision? Capital budgeting decision. Everybody following or not? A company wants to replace its labor intensive manufacturing by machine intensive manufacturing. They want to invest in a big machine. It is what decision? Capital budgeting decision. Are you following what I am saying? New product introduction, new project starting, new machine purchase. All this decisions are what decision? Are all capital budget decision. These decisions are not a decision for one day or one year. Then what the long term, I am going to have an impact over long number of years for the company. It is called as capital budgeting decision. Point number one, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Is what decision? Long term investment decision. Investment na, can I invest in new machinery? Can I invest in the new project? Can I start a new product and so on? So all these are what? Capital budgeting decisions. Okay, now the feature of this decision is all these decisions, the cash flows will look exactly same. The pattern of cash flow exactly looks same. How many types of cash flows are there? That is okay. But time value, leave it. Okay. How many types are there? Two types, inflows, outflows. Any decision when I make, I see the outflow, I see the inflow. Inflow more than outflow, good. Outflow more than inflow, bad. In all these decisions, in any decision, inflow and outflow is going to happen or not? In capital budgeting, what happens is, I'll be having a huge outflow. I'll be having what? A huge outflow in year zero. I'll be having what? A huge outflow in year zero. It is going to be followed by series of inflow for number of years, 5 to 10 years. Everybody follow what I'm saying? So how the cash flow pattern looks like is, I'll be having a huge outflow today. Why am I making huge outflow today? It is going to be followed by what? Series of inflows in future period is the nature of cash flow in capital budgeting problems. Are you following what I'm saying? I'll like give a simple example. Buying a house is capital budgeting decision or not? I want to buy a house. Buying a house requires an investment today. So no, I invest 60 lakh rupees to purchase a flat. I invest how much rupees? 60 lakh rupees to purchase a flat. Small investment, huge investment. For us, it is what? Your company, the 60 lakhs is maybe an annual expense. But for us, it's going to be what? A huge investment. So 60 lakhs I'm investing is a huge investment, right or not?
Yes,
why invest? Because when I invest 60 lakhs today, for another 40 years, suppose a building life is what? 40 years. For another 40 years, I can receive rent from it. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Or if I want to occupy for another 40 years, I can save rent payment.
Yes, sir.
Always decision is made to earn revenue or save cost. Always decision made to what? Earn revenue or save cost. Why I purchase a house? I purchase a house either to earn a rental income or avoid what? A rental cost. Inna parita na what I'm saying? In that case, this house investment is a capital budgeting decision for us. Inna parita. So what is the nature of cash flow? Year zero is what? Huge outlay. It is followed by what? Series of inflows. Are you following that? Now, to put it simply in Tamil, I'll say as Mottama Pote Childraya Purukkirathu. What is that? Mottama Pote Childraya Purukkirathu. Okay, now don't ask me to translate. Yeah, proverb should not be what? Translate. If you want to translate, I'll translate now. Huge outlay followed by what? Series of inflow. That's what I said. Are you following or not now? That's what I said in Tamil. Can I put it or not now? So it is a long term decision, not 1 or 2 years, long number of years, where year zero outflow followed by what? Series of inflows. What makes this decision very interesting or very important is that decision is irreversible as well as risky. Most of the time the decision is what? Irreversible as well as what? Risky. I'll say why it is risky. It is risky because the outlay is huge.
Yes,
10 rupees if I put, if it becomes loss, I lose only 10 rupees. Yeah. I invest 1000 crores, yeah, it becomes a bad project. It is going to be a huge loss for me, right or not?
Yes,
it is risky because the amount involved is what? Very huge. Stake is what? Very high. Sometimes company have gone into liquidation due to poor project decisions. Are you following what I'm saying? In that case, it's a risky decision because amount involved is very huge. Yes or no? It is risky because time involved is very long.
Yes,
it is not 1 or 2 years. I have to forecast for 5 or 10 years. Time involved is what? Very long. Risky because amount I am spending today, but I am going to get tomorrow.
Yes, sir.
Outflow certain. Outflow is what? Certain because I make the outflow today. What? Tomorrow what? Today. Today I make 1000 crores. But will I get back the money today, ma'am? No. I am going to get that money through what? Another 5 years, 6 years. Since the inflow occurs in future, inflow is uncertain. since the outflow occurs today, the outflow is what? Certain. I have a certain outflow, but what? An uncertain inflow that makes it risky. Are you following what I'm saying? All this make this decision a very, very risky decision, and very careful decision to be made very carefully, because it affects the solvency of a company itself in most of the cases. Everybody, are you understanding or not? Now, tell me why it is risky. Huge amount is involved. Why it is risky? Long period is involved. Why it is risky? Outflow today, certain. Inflow tomorrow. Answer. Tomorrow, no, not tomorrow. After 5 years, what is going to receive? I'm going to budget today.
Yes, sir.
It is not like a standard costing budget. Where you budget for 1 year.
Yes, sir.
Empty as you can budget for 1 year. The Nungamaga branch. Yeah. Can empty can budget for 6 years? Huh? 6 years. What is going to happen in CA market? Whether faculties are going to be famous for so many years, or the syllabus changes, CA institute closed down, nobody knows. Are you following what I'm saying? One exam. I'm saying it may become an integrated institute, CICAA, ACS. That is also under consideration. Are you following what I'm saying? In that case, anything may change in what? 6 years. So I have to forecast for what? A long period. That to companies, automobiles and all, long period forecasting very difficult, because every 1 year so many new models of car coming.
Yes, sir.
And for them, predicting demand, predicting cost, and all is what? Very huge task. So it is what? Very, very risky decision. Everybody following or not? Now, finally, that decision is also irreversible. Decision is what? Irreversible. Once you committed a mistake, you cannot come out of it easily without suffering huge cost. Now, I'll say one thing. Say, a Ford has built a car plant. Ford has built a car plant. Suppose in Chennai, Maraimalai Nagar already having a car plant. They built a new car plant, a small car plant to manufacture 1,000 cars. How many cars here? 1,000 cars. Okay. Now, after building the plant, okay, for manufacturing the Ford car, they found out that Ford car has got no great demand in this particular part of the country. Are you following what I'm saying? Now, can they close the plant? If they close the plant, they cannot sell it quite easily, because they cannot sell their car plant to Hyundai easily, because Hyundai car design is different than Ford. Is or no? This plant cannot be totally used for what? Manufacturing some other car, because it is tailor-made for this company. Are you following what I'm saying? A project cannot be sold like an onion or brinjal. Follow what I'm saying? Because a project is what? Something specific for a company requirement. If at all I sell, I have to sell only at a low price, because he knows that I am a distressor. He asks me surely what? Low price only. And all assets may not be useful for the other person. Everybody follow what I'm saying? So it is tailor-made decisions where if I make a commitment, it is going to be difficult to what? Come out of it without suffering huge losses. Is what is the feature of a capital budgeting decision. Why I discuss is to know what this decision is all about. Now, tell me, this decision is what decision? Long-term investment decision. How the cash flow pattern looks like? Huge outlay followed by series of inflow. Due to this, the decision is risky. The decision is also irreversible. This makes less, we have to use lot of techniques to properly evaluate the capital budgeting decisions. Point number one, everybody following or not? No. Next. Point number two is types of capital budgeting decisions. Accept, reject, mutually exclusive, capital rationing. Okay. Accept, reject means I accept good projects. I reject bad projects. That's all. Mutually exclusive means I select best of the available. I'll come to capital rationing later. Accept, reject, I accept good projects, I reject bad projects. Mutually exclusive means I select what the best. I'll give you example for both. Okay, see, accept, reject. My company fixes a standard. Any project gives me 10% return only will be accepted. What will be accepted? Any project gives me minimum how much return? 10%. Otherwise, I can put in FD. Are you following what I am saying? So the company says that I will accept whatever new project that comes my way. That gives me what? Minimum 10% return. Now, company is having three projects before it. Project A, Project B, Project C. Project A, Project B and Project C. Project A is expected to give 14% return. Accept or reject?
Accept.
Project B is expected to give 8% return. Accept or reject? It does not satisfy minimum requirement of 10%. I reject. I rather invest in what? FD for 9%. It is not. Project C is expected to give 11% return. Accept or reject?
Accept.
Whatever meets my standard will be accepted. Whatever does not meet my standard will be what? Rejected. I compare every option with the standard and see if it is meeting the standard or not. If it is meeting, accept it. Otherwise, what? Reject it. If all the project meets the standard, all of them will be accepted. If all does not meet the standard, all of them will be rejected. Some meets, some does not meet. What meets the standard, accepted. What doesn't will be rejected. Point number one. Yes or no? Now, next is mutual exclusion. Next is what? Mutual exclusion. Here, for example, I want to buy a machine. Brand A is available, brand B is available. That is company A and company A. Two companies are willing to supply me that particular machine. Very simple. I want to buy a laptop. Lenovo available, Dell available. Right or not? So now, will I buy both the laptop? What I will do? I'll sell the best. I said, want the best. Project A, project B. Both projects are available. A gives 16%, B gives 14%. One of them only I can watch. What is selecting here? 16%. So no, in that case, accepting one will lead to what? Rejecting others. It's called as what decision? Mutually exclusive decision. That is, both cannot be done. Only one of them should be selected. Five projects available, mutually exclusive means what? The best will be selected. Everybody yes or no? Accepting one leads to what? Rejection of others. We call it mutually exclusive decision. Any yes, sir. Simple as well. They might leave process and all. You are writing CA exam. Na?
Yes, sir.
CA exam is accept, reject, mutually exclusive. Yes, sir. CA exam is accept, reject, mutually exclusive. Accept, reject, because all of you can pass.
Yes, sir.
If all of you get have average 50 marks and 40 marks in all subjects, you clear C or not?
Yes, sir.
Just because Paul is passing, Rajagopal need not fail. It is not now. Because both can pass, both can fail. If it is not, that is, they compare your answer paper with the standard. Is your answer paper getting average 50 marks and 40 marks in every answer? If you all meet the criteria, you are accepted. Otherwise what? You are rejected. Yes or no? Now that you are clearing, now he will be failing. Or you will follow what I am saying. So everybody can clear, everybody can fail, somebody can clear, somebody can fail. It's called as what decision? Accept, reject decision, see examination. Right or not?
Yes,
sir. Correct? Now come to marriage. Come to what? Marriage. Okay. Now, marriage la, for a girl, 10 applications came. Application through the parents' horoscope. Okay, 10 applications came. Okay, now tell me, all the 10 persons well qualified, good looking, and earning what? Good salary. All 10 can be accepted.
Yes,
sir. Yes or no? No. What they do, the best will be selected. Yes or no? It is called as what? Mutual exclusion. It's called as what? Accepting one, rejecting what? Others. For others, you do not say reject. If you give the marriage invitation, they know what? We are rejected. Yes or no? So accepting one means what? Rejecting others. We call us what? Mutually exclusive. Enough for it or not? No. These are two types of decision. Third is capital rationing. Third is what decision? Capital rationing. Please. It is accept, reject. It is what? Accept, reject. But with the fund constraint. With what? Fund constraint. See, I have 1000 crores capital. I can raise 1000 crores capital. Company cannot raise unlimited capital. They have a capacity. They have what capacity to raise? Suppose this company can raise 1000 crores capital. Okay, now there are 6 good projects. There are how many good projects here? 6 good projects. We want to do all the 6. It requires 1400 crores. How many crores? 1400 crores. Can I accept all the 6? Within 1000 crores, what best can be done, those projects can be accepted.
Yes, sir.
It is not that accepting one rejected others, not so. Everything can be accepted, but all cannot be accepted because I don't have what? Money to do all of them. Within 1,000 crores budget, what all could be accepted? That could be accepted. It's called as what? Capital rationing decisions. Everybody follow what I'm saying? So accept reject na, compare with the standard, meets the standard, accept, doesn't meet the standard, reject. Mutually exclusive means compare with each other, the best will be what? Selected. Capital rationing is a type of accept reject decision only, but acceptance of all is not possible because of what? Fund constraint. So accept what is available within the given fund is called as the capital rationing decisions. Everybody following what I am saying? Now, in this capital rationing will be discussed as a separate problem area towards the end of this chapter. All the other sums done will be either accept reject or mutually exclusive. In a parade or not, accept reject now, good will be accepted. Mutually exclusive means what? Best will be accepted. Everybody follow what I am saying? Now, the types of capital budgeting decisions. Can I go to the next point or not? Now, data relevant for capital budgeting decision. Very, very important discussion. We'll understand the importance, we'll do big problems in the capital budgeting, namely cash flow estimation and decision making. This is a very important discussion. Again, seems more theoretical now, but it will be very useful when I recall these things at the time of doing problems in the later stages. I am now getting you introduced into the chapter. Everybody, can I present or not? Now, data relevant for capital budgeting decision. What is this we are going to discuss now? Let us understand it. See, you are the CMD of a company. CMD means what? Chairman and Managing Director, CEO, Chief Executive Officer, anyway called. You are the CMD of the company, the topmost post. Yes or no? You have a team, board of directors. CMD along with the board of directors are sitting in a very important board meeting. Important board meeting. The board meeting is to decide on a project. Decide on what? Project. A new project. Okay. Suppose it is opening of a new branch. Opening of what? You are the CMD of MTH Gar. Your successor Mahesh Shetty. Okay. So you are deciding about what? Opening a new branch. Okay. Can we open a new branch in Gulf country? Only MTG is there, can open a new branch in what? Gulf country, making lot of investment, catering to CFA, CMA, CEA, ICMA, etc. It is going to be a big project involving lot of investment of rupees. Okay, for MTG, I suppose it's going to be investment of 50 crore rupees we have to make, an investment for starting a new branch in Dubai. Above that, we are all discussing. I am also your board member, you are my boss, CMD. Can I put it or not? For example, yeah, okay. Now, at that time, we have to make a decision or not, whether the branch should be opened or not. Is an investment, 60 crores investment, have to decide whether it should be opened or not. Now, I require information. I call my CFO. I call my what? CFO. Who is CFO? Chief Financial Officer. He is the top finance force in any corporate. I call my CFO. He is also a part of the board only, as good as a part of the board members. So CFO has called and said, tell me CFO, can I open the branch in Mumbai or not? Tell me the idea, suggestion. He said, no problem sir, wait a minute. What he did there? He took out from his pocket a 1 rupee coin. Okay, put a toss. Head open, tail means want to close. Neither he kept and put a coin here. Yeah? It came as a tail. So sir, don't open. The branch should not be what open. He gave a suggestion. Tell me, good or bad? Why you say this bad? Because he is making decision by chance, not based on information. Always decision should not be made based on chance. Like that also make some decisions in final study area called as simulation. Generally we can't decide like that. That is foolish. We cannot make decision by chance. Foolish na? So why is it foolish or not? That is what Rajinikanth did. The Shivaji movie, now what is India? He put a coin, okay. Head means good way, tail means what the bad way. No, right or not? Suppose. Now, if you are asked now about CFO, you are laughing. Nah? Now, CFO put a task and said, Dubai branch open or not? He said, what? Open or close based on head and tail or not? Tell me, good or bad decision? Nah? You only said bad. Then how can Rajinikanth Khan alone make good decision by taking, saying, tossing a coin? They're also seeing that they're laughing. Aha, good decision. Yeah, okay. That is not a decision. Yeah. That is lottery. It is what a lottery only. Everybody, are you falling or not? It is decision based on what chance. It is illogical because any time in the life, no decision should be made on what choice. Available information should be collected. Considered a decision should be always what? Made. It may be right, it may be wrong. Somebody said, sir, he has succeeded. You understand that whether the decision is good or not does not depend on the success. Yes, sir. You know, we are deciding on future. Nobody in hand I can have in future. Decision is not based on success. Yeah. Good decision is based on how you make it. Yes, always how you make a decision only is what shows the caliber of a management, not whether decision is what successful or not. அதே ரஜினிகாந்துக்கு இஸ் அ சிங்கம் சிங்கிள் வரும் 5% பிடிஎம் இ டைட் யா சக்சஸ் ஆ என்ன இட் இஸ் கோயிங் டு வாட் ஃபெயிலியர் ஆர் யூ ஃபாலோ வாட் ஐ அம் சேயிங் நவ டிசிஷன் ஷட் பீ பேஸ்ட் ஆன் வாட் ஹவ் இட் இஸ் மேட் இன் திஸ் கேஸ் டிசிஷன் ஷட் பீ கன்சிடர்ட் டிசிஷன் பேஸ்ட் ஆன் இன்ஃபர்மேஷன் என்ன பரைடா நா கம் பேக் டு அவர் டிஸ்கஷன் ப்ளீஸ் வி செட் தட் வென் ஐ வாண்ட் டு மேக் எ கேபிடல் பட்ஜெட்டிங் டிசிஷன் I want the projections. I want what? Projections of the project. I want what? Projections of the project before it discussed. Yes or no? So I want to know what are all the possible inflows from the project. What are all the possible outflows of the project. Yes or no? I want data so that if the benefit is more than cost, I'll accept the project. If the benefit is what? Less than cost, I'll reject the project. So for making the decision, I require data. I require what? Data. Everybody understanding or not? Yes, sir. Now, the question is, data in today's world is available in plenty. Available in what? In plenty. Because any industry, any sector, any information you want, you can get from the Google. Yes or no? Yes, sir. Industry-wise data, sector-wise data, market size, customer demand, any projection will be having what? Lot of inputs available, country wise, region wise, segment wise, stock market, everything is what? Available. Getting data is not difficult, yes or no? But what is difficult is, out of the data which you are having, identifying what is relevant, what is irrelevant, is the technique, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Because you should not omit any relevant data, nor you should take any unrequired data. Both will make what? Mistakes in decision making. Are you what I'm saying? So when I say data, the data should be what data? Relevant data. What type of data you should be accepting? What type of data should not be considered? One should be knowing. Are you what I'm saying? So in the available data, one a good manager or a good management should knowing what they should take, what I should leave out is what we can say relevant data for what? Capital budgeting decision. Everybody following or not?
Yes, sir.
Very simple, yeah. That is a bird called as swan. Kelipattirukken. There's a bird called as what? Swan. Hamsa Pakshi or Anna Pakshi. Kelipattirukken. A bird called as what? Swan. Please. Don't ask me where it is. It is only in what? Literature. Okay. It is in Puranas or in all over the world. They accept a bird called as what? Swan. Ipo varudhu pa. Who shouted? Serious discussion media. Now come back. There's a bird called a swan. Okay. The ability of that bird is, if you mix water and milk and give it to it, what it'll do? It'll drink milk alone and leave water. How bird is not seen. Okay. Ask about crow, I will tell you, not about water swan. Okay. We give milk and water, it is the ability to what? Drink milk alone and leave water, water. Yes or no? No. That is the ability they say about that particular bird. Yes or no? No. We should be like a swan. We should be like what? Swan. When they give you relevant and irrelevant data, we should know the technique to pick out what? Relevant and leave out what? Irrelevant. Above that, this is discussed. Are you following or not? No. That is what I'm going to study in this area. Relevant data for capital budgeting decision. Let's start discussing point number one, point number two, and so on. All this are going to be adjustments. All these are going to be what? Adjustments in big capital budgeting problems. Can you start or not? No. Okay. Okay. First is, Consider cash flows on not accounting profits. Consider what? Cash flows on not accounting profits. When I make a capital budgeting decision, I want to start a new branch. Okay. What I will do, I project what are all the benefit I am going to get, what are all the costs I am going to spend. Yes or no? If the benefit is more than what cost, I'll accept. Otherwise what? I'll reject. Yes or no? In our subject, in this chapter, benefit is not income. Cost is not expense. Benefit is inflow, cost is outflow. I am not going to use the word income expense. I am going to use the word always what? Inflow and outflow. I don't believe in accounting profits. I believe in what? Real cash flows. Are you following what I am saying? So, when you evaluate a project, don't see every year how much profit the project earns. Always see every year how much cash flow the project is expected to give. Don't budget profits. Don't budget what? Profits. Budget what? Cash flows for the future period. Point number one. Very important point, the very important data. Tell me, in my subject, in this chapter, I say benefit is income, benefit is inflow. Benefit is what? Inflow. Cost is expense, cost is outflow. So the benefit of a decision is its inflows, and the cost of decision is its what? Outflows. When I do a capital budget decision, I'm going to budget above the project for another 5 years or not. For the next 5 years, what are all the income of this project, what are all the expense of this project I budget, or I budget what are all the inflows and what are all the outflows? I believe in inflows and outflows. I will not believe in what? Income and expenditure. Cash flow for decision making is always superior to accounting profit due to three reasons. How many reasons? Yeah, three reasons. You may say, sir, why can't I estimate, why can't I prepare budgeted P&L for what? 5 years and make a decision. Why not income expense? Why should be what? Inflow or flow? Question reasons na? Why should I measure my benefit in cash flows? Why should I not measure in what? Profits. A question arises now. Cash flows are superior always to what? Profit. I'll tell you three reasons. Reason number one. Okay. Now, I'll ask you, I go to the bank and submit my P&L. See, this year I have earned 1 lakh profit. Look at my P&L. Take the P&L. Give me interest. Will you give her? Sir, P&L is a paper. P&L is what? A paper. You may earn what? 1 lakh profit. Show me that 1 lakh. Everybody yes or no? Profit is paper tiger. Profit is not a paper tiger. It's only a paper amount. It is not a real value. Number right or not? Yes, sir. My 1 lakh profit, all sales may be credit. Yeah, correct. All sales may be what a credit. I am running short of cash. Yeah, follow what I am saying? In that case, the 1 lakh is not in my hand. 1 lakh is only in the P&L account. Yes, what if, can I invest P&L account? Can I invest P&L account and ask for interest? See, this year my company has earned a profit of 10 crore rupees. MTV takes a P&L account, deposits in Citibank and say, take my P&L account, 10 crore profit, give me interest. I say, don't give me 10 crore profit, give me 10 crore cash, I'll give you interest. Yes, and a P&L profit cannot give you any interest because it is only a paper profit. The real amount comes only when the cash comes in. Cash goes out. Yes or no? A company cannot sustain just by reporting profit. A company can sustain only when it has what? A lot of inflows and outflows. Are you following what I am saying? So profit, the first disadvantage is profit, we cannot apply time value of money. We cannot apply what? Time value of money. I cannot compound profit. I cannot what? Discount profit because profit is not a real. First year I earn 10 crores. I collect the 10 crores only in third year. That means, tell me, first year 10 crores will earn interest, third year 10 crores will earn interest. Third year. That means the 10 crores is received only in third year. I'll discount it from third year, not from first year because first year only profit reported, cash flow reported only in what? Third year. Time value of money can be applied, compounding and discounting can be done only for what? Cash flows. It cannot be done for what? Accounting profit. Since I cannot do compounding discounting for accounting profit, it will be rejected as a data. Yes or no? No. So when I ask a data from a CFO about a project, he should not give me budgeted P&L. He should be giving what? The budgeted inflows and outflows. Point number one. Are you following what I am saying? So now tell me, I will consider cash flow or accounting profit? Cash flow. Because cash flow considers what? Time value of money. Cash flow considers what? Time value of money. Reason number one. Yes, second reason why cash flow is superior to profit is, see, when I ask you to calculate profit, One person from this side, one person from that side. Both will give same profit. You may give one profit, she may give one, another profit, because you might have provided on the missionary WDV depreciation, she would have provided what? SLM. You use FIFO, she uses what? LIFO or valuation, right or not? You write off the goodwill over 10 years, she write off over what? 5 years. Accounting profit is subject to lot of policies, assumptions, etc. It is always confusing. We cannot tell one number, this is profit, nobody can hedge. Nobody can bet this is the profit of the company, because profit is always what? Ambiguous. Lot of assumptions are there, lot of policies are involved. So two persons can report what? Two profits. With that number, I cannot make a decision. Yeah, correct? But I'll give another example. I give you 10 lakh rupees bundle now to you, okay? I ask you to count. How much you will tell?
10 lakh.
Same 10 lakh bundle I give to her. I ask her to count. How much you will tell? If you have taken 1 lakh, we will counting, she will tell what? 9 lakh. Otherwise, will be what? 10 lakhs only. Yes or no? No. Anybody wants to estimate cash flow? Yeah? Cash flow does not have any assumption. What? Depreciation, goodwill, everything will not be what? That simply what comes in is what? Inflow. What goes out is what? Outflow. In that case, cash flow is less ambiguous. Profit is what? Ambiguous. Ambiguous, not confusing. Everybody following what I'm saying? So, cash flow is superior because cash profit is subjected to what? Lot of assumption. Cash flows are not. Everybody following what I'm saying? Now, so, now the third point is, why should I consider cash flow, not what? Profit. Now, my question is, I am going to buy a new machine. Why I buy a new machine? So that future years, I can make profit out of it. Kadaba. Isn't that correct? Now, future years, I make profit out of it or not? So today I buy what? New machine. Today when I invest in the new machine, I spend profit, I spend cash flow. The initial investment is made in cash. It is made in what? Cash. That means the future benefit should not be in profit, should be only in what? Cash. Yes, sir. Are you understanding what I am saying? If you make the initial benefit investment in cash, your outflow is in what? Cash. You cannot compare an outflow with the profit, because outflow is cash and profit is non-cash. Get what I am saying? In that case, this non-comparison, I cannot compare a donkey and monkey. Remember what I am saying? Remember only what? Two donkeys. Remember what I am saying? In that case, cash flows only should be compared with what? Cash flow. Since I make today, year zero, huge outlay is not huge loss. Huge outlay means what? Huge cash outflow. Since it is huge cash outflow, the benefit in future is also measured in what? Inflows only. So what I wanted to convey is, in our subject, we say income expense, inflow, outflow, always consider cash flows and not what? Accounting profit is the point number one I am going to discuss. Everybody understood or not? No. So because we are going to make decisions whether this is a good product or not. If you want to make a decision, I should estimate the cash flows and make a decision. So we have to not estimate profit, we should estimate what? Cash flow. If they give profit, what you will do? Convert the profit to what? Cash. Suppose they give profit of 10,000 rupees here. In the depreciation is 2,000, what do you do? Add back, giving them 12,000 rupees cash flow. Yes or no? How to convert a profit into cash flow? You are studying cash flow statement in the over. You are studying in what? Cash flow statement in the later stage, where how the profit can be converted into cash flow. We also do some easy conversions in the classroom in this chapter itself. Are you following what I am saying? So when they give you profit estimation also, you should be converting into what? Cash flow by eliminating non-cash items. Everybody, are you following what I am saying? This is the point number one. Consider cash flows and not accounting profit. Now, we will copy this. Before that, tell me what we are discussing now. To make a decision, I require data. I should not consider wrong data. I should consider what? Correct data. Now, profit is a wrong data, cash flow correct data. So, no. Now, how to take the data is the issue. In that point number one is, profit or cash flow? Measure the benefit in cash flows, not in what? Profit. Why? Tell me why cash flow is superior. Three reasons. Cash flow has got what? Time value of money. Profit cannot. So, no. Cash flow can be estimated more less ambiguously, and the profit is what? More ambiguous, because the assumptions, yes or no? Since I invest in cash, I should also measure the benefits also in what? Cash. I cannot invest in cash and measure in profits. In the parallel, follow what I'm saying? All this makes cash flow superior data compared to the accounting profit. Point number one, accepted? Huh?
Yes, sir.
Yes or no? No. Copy this before you go for point number two. give the heading data relevant for capital budgeting in the point number 1. Finish copying point 1.
No,
point number 1. Finish, huh? Second session, what about? Second session, accounts. Which chapter? Partnership over, full partnership. Company accounts? Company accounts over. Accounts over, huh? And then? That's all. Group 2, group 2 account spending, those who are not copying, raise your hand. Stop talking. Shh. Don't talk, please. Shh. What you are doing here? Yeah? Those who are not copying, raise your hand. Finish copying. Can I proceed? No. Please. I want to start a project. Please start. Stop. Please. I want to start a project. Whether to accept or not, should I put a toss and decide or based on data? What I will see, I'll see what are all the benefits from it, what are all the cost of the project, benefit more than cost, accept, otherwise what, reject. Should I measure the benefit as income and cost as expense up? No. I should measure the benefit as inflow and cost as outflow. Is the first point we have learned. So no, always believe in cash flows, don't believe in profits. Always do the estimates in cash flow, don't do the estimates in what? Profit. Consider cash flow, not profit. Point number one, over. Is or no? Point number two, do not consider all cash flows. Do not consider all cash flows. Consider only incremental cash flow. Consider only what? Incremental cash flow. Okay. Very important point. Lot of examples we'll see while doing the problems, but just I want to drive home the point, that's all. Okay. Should I consider all the cash flows of the project or only incremental cash flows? Incremental. I'll give you an example now for you to understand it. Look at this example. There is a project A. There's a project A. This is having a sales of 1 lakh. This is credit sales or cash sales? All this, when I say sales, I mean only what? Cash collection. Okay. Assume all are cash. Okay. Cash inflow is how much? 1 lakh. The materials for doing the project is suppose 50,000. How much of it is? 80,000. The wage cost of this project is 40,000. From this project every year, what the inflow? From the project, what the inflow? 1 lakh. What the outflow? 1 lakh 20. The project each year when I start this will give me net inflow or net outflow or net outflow, the net outflow 20,000. Straight away reject. Is or no? Investment would buy every year. I don't get any inflow. Every year is what? Outflow more than inflow. A very worst project. I'll reject the project. Is or no?
Yes, sir.
Because the outflow is 1 lakh 20, inflow is only what? 1 lakh. I have what? -20,000. I will not accept it. Is or no?
Yes, sir.
Now, I will now add a data to it. I'll add a data to it. How much labor cost? 40,000. What I say is, wages of 40,000 is paid to an existing employee who at present is idle and is being proposed to be used for the new project. Now, understand the data. The data is, I am opening a new branch. I am opening what? New branch. The new branch I am suppose opening for MTS opens a new branch, say in Kodambakkam. Example, in what? It is Nungambakkam. Next branch is in what? Kodambakkam. Okay. Now, for the new branch, yeah, employees required or not? Okay. What I do is, I transfer a person from Nungambakkam branch to what? Kodambakkam branch to look at that particular branch. Understood? Okay, Satish, I transfer what? Satish from, afraid or not afraid? Then surely I'll transfer, okay? I'll transfer Satish from Nungambakkam branch to what? Kodambakkam branch. Okay, now. Satish, in the example, okay, Satish at present is doing nothing in Nungambakkam. He's doing what? He is coming here as, okay. I said the example. He's coming here, sleeping, going home. Coming here, sleeping, going home. It passed. Not only, you are also doing the same thing here. Let's come back to the discussion now. For example, Satish is coming here, sleeping, going home. Coming here, sleeping, going home. Okay. For that, suppose he is drawing a salary of 40,000. Any problem? No. Okay, now. Can I proceed up? Now. I am starting a new project. I am starting what? New project. Nungambakkam. That requires an employer or not? So what I do is, I transfer Satish to Nungambakkam branch. Are you pronounced? Sir, Kodambakkam branch. Please stop talking. Now. Come to the concept here. Now, that 40,000 is not at all an outflow because it is non-incremental. It should be eliminated. It should be rejected. The reason is, understand that. If I start projecting, will I get 1 lakh sales? நம்ம சொல்லுப்பா, எஸ் ஆனோவா? எஸ். இஃப் ஐ டோன்ட் ஸ்டார்ட் ப்ராஜெக்ட், வில் ஐ கெட் 1 lakh சேல்ஸ்? நோ. தட் மீன்ஸ் 1 lakh சேல்ஸ் இஸ் டியூ டு ப்ராஜெக்ட். கரெக்டா? இஃப் ஐ ஸ்டார்ட் ப்ராஜெக்ட், வில் ஐ பை 80,000 மெட்டீரியல்ஸ்? இஃப் ஐ டோன்ட் ஸ்டார்ட் ப்ராஜெக்ட், வில் ஐ பே த 80,000? நோ. த 80,000 அவுட்ஃப்ளோ அரைசஸ் டியூ டு வாட்? த ப்ராஜெக்ட். கரெக்டா? இஃப் ஐ ஸ்டார்ட் ப்ராஜெக்ட், வில் ஐ பே சதீஷ் 40,000? சொல்லுப்பா. When I start Kodambakkam branch, will Satish get 40,000? Yes. When I don't start that branch, will he get 40,000? Yes. Whether I start the project or don't start the project, he anyhow receive what? That money. It becomes non-incremental, irrelevant. Yes, sir. You know, that cash flow does not occur due to the project. This is anyhow going to happen. Yes or no? Yes, sir. So the simple test is this number due to project? Is this number what? Due to project. If yes, it is a relevant data. What is that? If this number is anyhow going to be there, it becomes what? Irrelevant data. Yes or no? Is the sales due to project, Eva?
Yes, sir.
Yes or no? Yes. Project there, it is there. Not that, it won't be there. Right? Is the material cost due to project, Eva? Yes. You know, if the project there, material cost there. No project, I won't buy the material. Yes or no? But this wages is not paid to a new employee, is paid to all already having employee who is idle. Instead of sleeping here, go there and sleep. That's one decision. So what I'm saying, in that case, it is already remaining what? Idle. When I start project A also, I pay 40. If I don't start A also, what? I pay 40. The 40,000 is not due to project A. Yes or no? He may work in project A, but his point is not due to what? Project A. It becomes an irrelevant cost because it is not incremental. It is not what? Incremental. Anything extra happens to the project only should be considered. What is already happening should not be considered. In the paisa, no. The word incremental means what? Extra. When I start the project, I get extra 1 lakh. When I start the project, I pay what? Extra 80,000. When I start the project, I don't pay extra what? 40. I pay what? The same 40 only. Yes or no? Suppose when I start a new project, listen, when I start what? New project, I transfer this person to a new project and fix him a salary of 50. So fix him a salary of what? 50. Because till now for sleeping is getting 40, now he's going to want what? 10,000 rupees what? Increment I'm giving. Okay, now tell me what the incremental labor cost? 10,000 become relevant because due to the project it become what? 50. Without project, 40. What the extra due to project? 10,000. That becomes the incremental cash flow. Respond, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Should I consider all the cash flows of the project or only incremental? What are incremental cash flow? Those cash flow that arises due to the project under consideration is called as what? Incremental. Those cash which anyhow happens are what? Non-incremental. Everybody yes or no? No. We are going to use this concept in every problem to be done in cash flow estimation. Are you following this concept or not? No. So that's what I'm writing here. The answer is sales inflow and material outflow are what? Incremental cash flow because they occur when the product is accepted and would not occur when the product is what? Rejected. However, the labor is not incremental cash flow because it will be paid whether or not project is accepted. Do you understand this point or not? So tell me, I should believe in income expense or inflow outflow? I should consider all inflows and all outflows are only incremental. Only incremental. What is incremental? If a number purely comes due to that project, it becomes what? Incremental. Yet anyhow is that becomes what? Non-incremental. In number right or not? No. This is a point number two. Everybody understanding it? No. So copy this. Again, I say it may seem to be more theoretical now. I am just putting all this into your ears and mind so that when I do big problems, I'll be able to recollect it and show live examples. Are you following what I'm saying? Now, these are all heart of major capital budgeting problems. Okay, now please note it down. Stop talking. Finish copying, huh? Those who are not copied, raise your hand. Can I proceed? No. Those who did not copy, raise your hand. Shh. Now finish that. Finish now. Those who are not copy, raise your hand. Sikaramba, copy fast. Shh. Shall I proceed? Now, next, please. Don't believe in profits, believe in cash flow. Don't consider all cash flows, consider only incremental cash flow after tax. Accepted? Now, please. I want to start a new project, please. In year zero, it requires an outflow of 100 crores, in an initial investment, right or not? It is expected to give, all these are budgeted numbers, expected to give first year, second year, third year, suppose 40 crores, 30 crores and 40 crores. Example, are you following what I am saying? Now, these are all profit, cash flows. Each year I'll be having income as well as what? Expense. All cash incomes and cash expenses should be netted off. This is the inflows of each and every year. Yes or no? Now, I make an investment today 100 crore. The product is going to give me what? First year and 40. Second 30. Third year what? 40. Forget time will happen for the time being. Just to understand easily, what is the inflow of the product used totally? 110. What the outflow? 100 crore. So is a 110 recovering my investment or not? Yes. It recovers my investment. Do you mean 10 crores also what? Extra. Seems to be a good project. Enough right or not? But understand that each year when the project gives me 40 crores, the entire 40 crores does not belong to me. Because a part of it should be given to government as tax. So what is balance only is available to recover my what? Investment and give me some additional inflows. Everybody follow what I am saying? So whenever I estimate cash flow, don't estimate cash flow. Estimate what? Cash flow after tax. Always estimates what? Cash flow after tax. Any cash flow, if it has a tax implication, you should what? Predict that also and incorporate into your budgeting process. Everybody, are you following or not? So the word cash flow, now cash flow after what? Tax. Very simple. All the inflows will result in tax outflow. Any inflow you get results in what? Tax outflow. All the outflows will result in what? Tax inflow or tax savings. Do they understand it or not? No. Very simple. I receive a sales of 1 lakh. I receive what? A sales of 1 lakh. It increases profit or decreases profit? Increases profit. So when the profit increases by 1 lakh, there's a tax increase of 30,000. So when there's an inflow, there's an increase in what? Tax outflow. You know what I'm saying? Similarly, I pay wages 40. For example, I pay wages, how much wages? 40,000. When I pay 40,000 wages, there's 40,000 wage I debit to P&L, credit to P&L. Again I say, all inflows is going to result in what? Tax payments. All outflows is going to result in what? Tax savings. Now, for example, I have a collection from sales, 1 lakh. That 1 lakh sales collection is going to increase profit or decrease profit? Profit goes up by 1 lakh. Tax goes up by 30,000. The 1 lakh inflow results in 30,000 outflow. Get up a tax. Yes, sir. Similarly, I pay wages of 40. I pay wages of what? 40. 40 outflow or not?
Yes, sir.
40,000 outflow. But this 40,000 outflow, I can debit in P&L. Right or not?
Yes, sir.
If I debit in P&L, it decreases the profit by how much? 40,000. When the profit decreases by 40,000, 30% on 40,000, how much it pays? 12,000. Tax is saved or not? Save tax is a redeemed inflow, is or no?
Yes,
in our subject, inflow need not be actual inflow. A saved outflow also is what? Deemed inflow only. Enough or not? Now tell me, when I estimate cash flows, inflow results in what? Tax outflows. And outflow results in what? The tax savings. So when I say cash flow, I should always mean what? Cash flow after tax. Yes or no? No, because that is only available to recover my investment. You know, the government takes the required sum automatically. Can I proceed? No. So the third point is, you should consider not all cash flows. Consider only what? Cash flow after tax. Okay. So project is done for the benefit of shareholders. Any benefit from the project will not be fully available to shareholders. Since a part of it should be parted to the government by way of what? Taxation. Enough right or not? No. So what happens is, inflows of a project will increase tax outflows, and conversely, outflows of a project will save what? Tax. Thus, inflows and outflows should be adjusted for relevant tax flows before making decision. Therefore, cash flow means what? Cash flow after tax is the next issue. Everybody following or not? No. Note it down before I go for the next point. Please note down quickly. Finished, huh? Yes, shall I proceed? Yes, can I put the next slide or not?
Yes,
who have not copied? Raise your hand. Finished, huh? So when there is an inflow, what happens to tax? Tax outflow. Outflow means tax savings. Both will happen. Okay. You need not cry that I'm paying 40,000 expense, because the 40,000 expense saves me what? 12,000 tax. The net expense I pay is only 28,000. Is or no? Similarly, when I get 1 lakh sales, don't be happy I'm getting what? 1 lakh. You know, statism goes to what? Government. The net inflow is only what? 70,000. Always inflow results in tax outflow. Outflow also saves you tax. Finished, huh?
Yes,
stop talking. Those who are not copied, raise your hand. Shall I proceed on? Okay, now please listen here. Understand the context. I want to make a decision whether to accept a project or not to accept the project. Everybody, please. Can I put a toss and say accept or reject? No. I should assess the benefit and cost of the decision and then make the decision. Can I measure the benefit and cost as income and expenditure? No. We should measure as what? Inflows and outflows is point number one. Are you following?
Yes, sir.
I should measure it as inflows and outflows is point number one. Right or not? No. All inflows and all outflows, can it be considered? No. When you look at the inflow outflow also, see only what? Incremental. What is extra inflow? What are the extra outflows due to this project only should be considered. But anyhow going to happen, whether or not the project is going to be taken up, should be ignored. So don't consider all cash flow. Please look at only what? Incremental cash flow was our second point. Yes or no? Now, next issue. All incremental cash flow, can I consider not? Don't say like that, because any cash flow when it comes in, it does not fully belong to you, because a part of it belongs to what? Government. So whenever I say cash flow as a benefit, it should be cash flow after paying what? Tax. So the word cash flow should be always understood be what? Cash flow after tax. Inflows results in what? Tax outflows. And outflows, on the other hand, is also going to save you tax. So both should be considered while making the decision. Everybody, are you following what I am saying? So the word cash flow means cash flow after tax. Can I proceed up? Now, next point is depreciation. It is one of the really regularly adjustment in the every sum. Okay, next is what? Depreciation. Now, tell me, any project when I start, I have to make an investment in year zero or not?
Yes, sir.
The investment will mean assets. I start a new project, na, I buy plant, machinery, etc., etc. I invest in what? Assets. All those assets will give me depreciation or not? My question is the depreciation expense relevant or irrelevant for making a decision? Depreciation is to be considered or should be ignored? Prima facie, tell me, should be considered or ignored? Ignored. Why should we ignore depreciation? It is not a cash flow, it is just a book entry.
Yes,
just because I provide 10,000 depreciation, don't think 10,000 outflow happens. Now already year zero outflow happened.
Yes,
when invest in 100 crores in year zero, that only become depreciation later. So now already 100 crore considered. Should I consider depreciation? Ignore it. Ignore depreciation. Point number one. Yes or no? Why depreciation expense should be ignored? It is an expense, it is not an outflow. Everybody following or consider only what? Cash flows. But when they have tax, when they have what? Tax, it is to be considered as well as what? Ignored. How it should be done, I will now show you. Can I put it or not? Now look at this. Next adjustment is what? Capital budgeting and depreciation. Listen here. There are two projects here. There are what? Two projects. Both projects earn same profit. The PBDT I call. What is PBDT? Profit before reducing depreciation and paying tax. This is 1 lakh, 1 lakh. Assume both are cash profit. There's no debtors, no creditors. Both are what? Cash flows. Yes or no? No. PBDT, profit before depreciation tax. How much is there? 1 lakh, 1 lakh. Based on this, both projects are equally good. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Now, suppose depreciation. Project A equipment is allowed a depreciation of 30,000 and B a depreciation of 20,000. From the PBDT, if I reduce what? Depreciation. From the profit before depreciation and tax, reduce what? Depreciation. What it is what? Profit before tax, I call as PBT. We call as what? PBT. What profit before tax? 70,000, 80,000. On this only we'll calculate tax. Yes or no? Now for income tax purpose, depreciation is expense, even though not an outflow. Yes or no? They allow the debit in the P&L account or not? Now, I calculate tax for project A 50%, for example, for easy understanding, on how much rupees? 70,000. What the tax amount? 35,000. Project B, what the tax amount? 40,000. PBT minus tax is your PAT. That means what? Profit after tax. What the profit after tax? 35,000. And then what? 40,000. Everybody, yes or no? No. Can I say A is giving 35,000 profit, B is giving what? 40,000 profit. Select B. Is my comparison right or wrong? Or wrong? I should not decide based on profit. I should decide based on what? Cash flow. Why I don't call this as cash flow? Because inside this 35,000, I have reduced a non-cash item called as depreciation. Is or no?
Yes, sir.
So what I should do? I should add back depreciation, because to the profit, if I add back the non-cash, I get what? The cash profit. It's not what I'm saying. I add back depreciation. What the depreciation amount? 30,000. What the depreciation amount? 20,000. The net number I call as CFAT. That means what? Cash flow after tax is 65,000, and then what? 60,000. Everybody, are you following or not?
Yes, sir.
I reduce depreciation to calculate tax. I add it back because it is a non-cash item. Is it or no?
Yes, sir.
You may ask, sir, why should I reduce? Why should I what? Add back. Can I ignore it or not? I should not ignore, because see, without tax, A and B are equally good. Get up. Before tax, A also gives 1 lakh, B also gives 1. 1 lakh. Cash flow, cash flow after tax. But before tax, both gives you the same cash flow. After tax also, they should give the same cash flow or not? But after tax, A gives 65 and B gives what? 60. Romba simple. Before tax, we both earn the same amount. Tax also same percentage. After tax, both should be having the same amount or not? But A has 65, B has what? 60. Tell me, why A is having more profit? Shulpa. Why A is having more cash flow? Tell me. Because A is having 10,000 rupees extra depreciation, on which it is able to save what? 5,000 extra tax. A pays only 35 tax and B pays what? 40 tax. Why pay less tax? Because A has what? More depreciation. Yes or no? No. Depreciation is non-cash. I accept. Depreciation is what? Non-cash. But depreciation protects you. It what? Protects you against tax, because it is a tax deductible expense. Are you following what I am saying? This is what we call as tax shield on depreciation, or tax shelter on depreciation. So depreciation is cash or non-cash? Depreciation is what? Non-cash. But depreciation has got the ability to increase your cash flow. Has got what? Ability to increase the cash flow, because depreciation reduces tax. When tax is reduced, cash flow what? Increases. Yes or no? No. Because B is having only 20,000 depreciation. A has what? 30,000 depreciation. A has 10,000 extra depreciation. So it saves what? 5,000 tax. So the cash flow is more by what? 5,000. The 5,000 is not due to project. It's due to what? Depreciation on the asset. Yes or no? I reduce depreciation to calculate correct tax, and then what? I add it back. Consider depreciation when there is what? Taxation, because it gives you tax benefit. It gives you what? Tax shield. Are you all following what I'm saying or not? So whenever in any problem depreciation comes, what you should do? PBDT minus depreciation, PBT minus tax, PAT, add depreciation, uses CFAT. CFAT means what? Cash flow after tax. Everybody, are you understanding it or not? That's the one should give the depreciation adjustment, regular adjustment in most of the sums. Are you following, huh? That's what I'm not discussing here. Depreciation prima facie. What meaning of prima facie? On the face of it. Is what a non-cash expenditure, and hence should be ignored for capital budgeting decision. Is or no? However, when taxation is there, depreciation being a tax deductible expense results in what? Tax savings. This savings in tax outflow due to depreciation is referred to as what? Tax shield or tax shelter on depreciation. Shield, na, we have a sword, we have what? A shield. Sword will be used to what? Strike other. Shield is what? Defend. Okay. Government is coming with a sword to kill you using what? Tax. What do you show them? Depreciation. Save yourself. It's all known now. It is called as what? Tax shield or tax. Can I proceed? Tax shield or cash shelter on depreciation. Now, the motto is, no taxation, no depreciation. If taxation, then depreciation. That is, you are doing a capital budgeting in Dubai. Okay. In that case, ignore what? Depreciation, because there's no tax in that country. You need not consider depreciation, because it does not provide you tax shield. Is or no? But in countries where taxes are present, you should consider depreciation to calculate right tax. And then once again what? Add back, because it's going to be a non-cash is the issue. Everybody, are you following or not? Either depreciation and capital budgeting. Please copy this quickly before you go for the next one. First to copy, then we'll decide. Okay. Shh. Stop talking. finish copying, huh? Stop talking, please. Finish copying, huh?
Yes,
okay. You copy from others, yeah? Copy this quickly. Too slow. Okay. Finish copying, huh? Stop talking. So, two more points are left. Cash flow adjusted for side effects and working capital adjustment. We'll discuss this in the next class and do all the capital budgeting techniques. We have two sessions in the Friday class. We'll do payback, discounted payback, NPV, IRR, PI, all this we'll be discussing in the next class.